Hello and welcome back to DragonFable. I've started recording this before I've uploaded the last of the Tomics story, so I'm not sure how long it has been for you, hopefully not too long. I've also, because I've started recording this in advance, not quite seen the results of the poll whether to use the Dragonlord or the Soul Weaving armor, but we'll just stick for the Dragonlord armor for this episode anyway, and we'll see what armor we use in the next episode. As I've stated in last episode, we are now going to learn about the most important element of the day, Bacon from Valencia, who also helped us with retrieving the dragon egg. We're now going to do Bacon Origin. I'm glad you're here, Dekia. I have a little favor to ask of you. It has to do with a very rare element I've recently heard about. A rare element? Well, you've heard of elements like ice, wind, earth and all. This element is strange, though. It appears to be bacon. Bacon. Exactly, bacon. Now, in all my wanderings, I've never come across such an element, which is why I am very interested in learning all about it. Bacon is pretty interesting. I really want to know more about element bacon. Please see what you can find out. And these are a lot of quests. These are not even all quests. There's still the more button left. And here, the search begins. You might want to start hunting for information in the Falcon Reach Guardian Tower. I know its library has many tomes full of obscure information. Hello, Dekia. How can I help you? I'm looking for information you have on element bacon, and it looks like I have a ton of searching to do in all those books. Unless you know something that might help me instead. I know each of those volumes by heart, and there's not a thing in them about element bacon, I'm sorry. From what I can tell, the bacon element is relatively new to this area. I haven't seen any mention of it in the older writings we have. I see. Do you know anything else, possibly? Well, I don't, but I might be able to help you find someone who does. I've heard of someone up on a mountain to the east who might know more. Some hermit, maybe. The traveler I spoke to was a bit dazed and didn't say much more than, "So bright, so wise." Oh, at that point he started blowing bubbles in his oatmeal. Are you sure he was sane? Because it sounds like he was more crazy than dazed. Do you have any better place to look for information? Now that you mention it, no. Valencia said to start my search here, and it looks like you're sending me on a wild goose chase. After some hermit who may or may not actually exist. Exactly. Good luck. Okay, here we go then. There is a strange barrier over here. My god. Well, this isn't at all what you expected. Greetings, mortal! Pardon me. Frog in my throat. Get Zooks! No, god. Zooster. Which is to say, me. You're a chicken cow. Close. I'm the chicken cow god. What did you expect? I don't know, a hermit or something? Maybe a wise old retired martial artist looking to dispense wisdom with a big stick in the guise of training?
He's two mountaintops over, sorry. If you make your way down now, you might reach him before sunset. Be prepared for a lot of wood chopping and water carrying, though.
What? No, you know what? Never mind. I just want to know about bacon. Bacon is tasty, if a bit greasy. Does that help? Everyone's a comedian. I prefer to think of it as dispensing wisdom with humor. Why do you ask about bacon? Do you know anything about the element bacon?
Why, yes, I do. But who are you to be asking about that?
I'm just curious.
I did not ask why you were asking about element bacon. I asked who you were to be asking. That knowledge is not just for anyone.
Oh, well, I'm pretty deserving, honest. I can fight things and win and help people. Do you need help with anything, maybe?
I suppose you could prove your worthiness.
Oh, yes, I'm good at proving things. Why, just the other day.
Fine. You can start by doing a little chore for me, and if you prove successful at that, we'll see what else you can do. I'll leave the details with your nosy friends by the ostentatious statue in the woods.
How do you know about Valencia?
Omniscience is handier for more than impressing chicks at parties.
Don't gods usually like big golden statues, though?
Yes, we do, but this one isn't of me, now is it?
I see your point. Chickencows are ruled by a rooster god. Yes, and the rooster god is called Zooster, like rooster. I've been playing this game for 12 years and I recently found out that its name is a pun. Alright, he's a lion. So, a chicken cow god, you come across the strangest people and animals. Anyways, his messenger left this letter for you. If you truly wish yourself worthy to know more about our secrets, then you'll need to start proving yourself. You can start by taking care of a rather unusual individual I find myself too busy to deal with. The vileness of his slander is making my attendants weep. Oh, and I advise you to not believe a word of what he says, Zooster. Three at once, Better defense, we also have a multi-strike attack, of course, but that is of the energy element. We don't have a choice, it's the attack is automatically elementalized to energy, and these creatures are mostly resistant to energy, so we can't use the multi-attack, so we had to defend. But that's also working out for us, I think. Healing mushrooms. Don't do mushrooms, kid. A uni cougar. Don't do cougars, kid. Excuse me, but I'm looking for a troublemaker who's maligning a chicken cow named Zooster. Have you heard any rumors or malicious gossip being spread about chicken cow deities lately? Dragon Lord, you have lived too long alone if you would run errands for a creature such as Zooster. Oh, I guess I'm looking for you then, aren't I? He and his flock of foul, bird-brained attendants lounge around accepting tribute while his lackeys scurry like rodents, trying vainly to hide the evidence of misdeeds and mistakes. Be you a mouse or a man? Last I checked, I was human, so I guess I'll take option B. I'm sure you have some sense, as I can see you are forthright and honest. But surely that sense is muddled and confused if you are playing the part of Zooster's foul minion. Well, I really want to know more about Element Bacon, and Zooster has promised to tell me. What has he done to you for you to be so rude to him? He seems like a good enough sort, though I keep expecting a chorus of trumpets to play when he appears. Ah, Zooster, verily he is a poxed, plume-plucked malcontent. His face is false and must hide what his false heart and mind plot. I'm afraid I don't quite follow you. You should be wary of what slips past his lips. Yes, lips? Perhaps my assessment of you possessing sense was overly hasty. Hey, I am full of sense. Sensitive, even. Has anyone ever told you that you're nothing but a big bully? I see why Zooster is so irritated. My intelligence is not so lacking that I cannot see through the lies hidden in a puffed-up, coxcomb, honey-tongued prattle. Begone, you infect my eyes with your presence. I'm afraid I can't do that. You see, I have pledged to prove myself, and prove myself I will. then you are surely as beef-witted a hedge-pig as your poisonous patron. A poor, mindless dragon lord sneaking home to display the fruits of puny efforts in the hope of a crumb of praise. That's it. When I'm through with you, there won't be enough scraps of hide left to make a cape. Samian Lion? He's a lion. What's the title of the quest? It's weak to water and ice, so we still have our water weapon equipped. We do get the stun. I don't think he will be too difficult. You know, I think there is enough to make a cape after all. That didn't seem so mean, but perhaps Zeus's attendants are really, really sensitive. So we've now done our first task for Zeuster, and there are a lot, and I mean a lot of tasks left to do. And I've recently read that the quests we need to do for Zeuster are supposed to be representative of the 12 labors of Hercules. And personally, I think that it is really, that's so cool. I really take my hat off to the developers. But I do want to keep this video under an hour long. So that means that we don't have time to do all the 12 labors. So we're going to skip ahead a few quests. And if you're hearing music right now, we're going to do that by means of a short montage. It sounds like you've been far too busy to get bored. You can say that again. And things aren't about to slow down anytime soon. Zeuster would like you to take care of a boar that's been on the rampage, scaring the Chickencows. It sounds like a pretty ferocious beast. And the next time you're in town, you might want to stop by Yoga's Forge. I hear he's made up a new batch of smoothies. As good as they are, you might want to take care of the boar first. I hear the townspeople hunting for it haven't had any luck. Greetings, Dekia. Excellent timing. I just finished making a batch of those strawberry smoothies I know you crave. Well, I suppose it couldn't hurt to stop and have just one mug. I'm supposed to be hunting some rampaging creature or other, a boar, a bear. Valencia mentions your smoothies while she was telling me about my task, but I got a bit distracted. I know it's got four legs and sharp teeth. I'm sure accepting my hospitality won't slow you down too much. One mug won't take long to finish. Your logic is difficult to argue, and it wouldn't do to be rude when you've helped me so much. Pass the jug. Try some, it's my best batch yet. That was very good indeed. Yilger? What did you put in this? Oh, you know, this happened the last time I made smoothies, but those were blueberry pineapple. I didn't think it would happen with the strawberry flavor. Did you need that door, really? You might have to think about switching to baking. I hear cookies don't cause much destruction.
Dekia, go. I can handle these. You go help clear out the rest of the town. Major Rafe is not going to be pleased. Hey, Twilly. Twilly, have you seen a wild boar today? There are many boars all over. There's one, there went that way, over there. Alright, thanks, Twilly. I'll just have to kill them all one by one until I find the one I'm looking for, I think. Great. That looks like the boy we need to find. Next to the healing fountain, that's very convenient, though we're so strong we don't need that. There you are! Who's afraid of the big bad boar? The big bad boar, not me! Okay, not a big musical fan, got it. I guess diplomacy using nonsense songs isn't really that effective now that I think about it. Battle it is! Raging boar. No resistances, so that's going to be very easy, I'd say. Unless he does amazing damage. You were great, Dekia. The last time town was invaded, the mayor said if things ever got so out of control again, he was relocating his office. But the treasury is almost bare! Exactly. He says he'll... Exactly. He says he'll make the townsfolk pay the moving costs. Claims that if he has to deal with the headaches our mistakes cause, we should have to ease his stress somehow. So, since neither of us want to finance a three-story marble-floored pirate shanty in Osprey Cove, it's a good thing you took care of that mess. You know, I bet Mayor Rafe would get along really well with Zooster. Yeah, I think so too. It's hard to be bored when animals are going wild. You might want to help Yoga clean up his forge too, since he did make the smoothies for you. Alright, good point, fair point. Dekia, I have good news and not quite as good news for you. Zooster writes that he is beginning to feel that you could be worthy of that secret you're hunting after all. Wow, thanks. That was the good news. The not quite as good news is that he isn't quite sure yet and needs more convincing, yeah. He says he'll tell you all you need to know for this next task when you get to the Mage Priest dorm stable. Good luck, Dragon Lord. Thank you, Valencia. So, Zooster, here I am, back at the Mage Priest Apprentice dorm stable. What did you want to meet me here for? Dekia, good. Archimedes and I have a task for you. I was expecting something like that. You know I'm happy to help, but what will it be this time? Wrestling a mutant dog? Fighting a snake woman? Oh, nothing so difficult. We just want you to take our apprentices here to visit their relatives, the cattle of Durian. You want me to babysit all of them? Well, you did say you knew how to be useful. Just be careful, you know what kinds of mischief young apprentices can get into. Okay everyone, here we are. Stay together now, your relatives aren't supposed to be either in the field or in the barn. Moop! 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 What? Look behind me? Bird juice making faces behind my back? Moop! Oh crap. I did not plan for a game of hide and seek farm edition. Here, Chickencows, come out, wherever you are. Ah, monsters appear. You didn't think babysitting would be this hard, but you found one of the scattered babies. Oh god, we need to find 10.
Here you all are. Wait, you aren't all here.
They most certainly are not. I saw the other half of the flock hurt scatter across the direction of the barn.
Good to know, thank you. And by the way, I call a group of chicken cows a flirt. It just seems to make sense.
Aha! Now I found all of you. That's the last time I let Zooster and that sweet-tongued mage priest of his talk me into chick-sitting.
Do these infants belong to you?
Not really. Nope. I'm supposed to be taking them to see you. Akimudis didn't send word?
He most certainly did not.
Oh, I see. Well, surprise! Your distant hybrid rowdy little relatives have come to see you.
Seeing us does not include using me as an object of recreation, if you ask me.
Moop, 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 meep.
Moop, 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 meep.
But I think it's time to be going now. Those are some lovely long curved horns you have. Come, check calves. We'll eat on the way home.
Moop, 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 moop.
There aren't any ice cream or candy shops on the way back, so on second thought, souvenirs from the farm's gift shop will have to do. You found all the chick calves and managed to get skewered on a set of Jurian's cow's horns. I'd call this trip a success. I believe this is a pun, but I don't understand it. Sadly. It's really quite unfortunate. Hello, Dekia. It sounds like Zooster has another task for you, since you handled yourself so well with the chick calves. Look at you. He says in his latest letter that one of his favorite attendants has pleased him with her devotion and he would like to give her a gift in thanks. But he wants it to be a very special present, not just any old trinket. He's heard of a magical belt worn by the Queen of the Jungle Furies and he has his hybrid little heart set on giving it to her. Which is where you come in. You'll need to journey into the jungle and retrieve the belt by any means necessary. Oh, and he says he's heard Queen Lita likes presents, so giving her some gifts might help her part with her belt. Good luck.
Alright.
Found a tribute. His bag of gold.
Oh, I missed a bit there.
As a young girl, I grew very angry at being denied the training my older brothers were received in arms and combat. I used to watch them and practice in secret. When my parents found out, they were furious and forbid me to continue. In a rage, I ran away and into the jungle. I quickly got lost and could not find my way home. This tribe of jungle furies found me. I showed them how to better defend themselves by flinging their feathers at attackers, and so they adopted me and elected me queen.
So you're the one who taught them how to do that. Gee, thanks a lot.
Why have you come here? We welcome peaceful visitors, but they are so rare.
Your furiness, I am here to beg a favor. Zooster, the proud and lovely lord of the chicken cows, is very interested in acquiring your belt.
It is a very nice belt. It was given to me at my coronation.
To that end, I come bearing gifts worthy of one so ferocious and powerful as you are wildly known to be.
Gifts? My sisters do like sparkly things. Give tribute.
Your gifts are nice, sort of, but they're just things you picked up in the jungle. I have a whole clearing full of these flowers and crystals right over there. Hardly proper tribute for a queen.
So you're not going to give me the belt?
Nope.
Pretty please, I even gave you the bag of gold I found.
No.
But I really need that belt. Here, you can have mine instead. It's a good trade.
Not a chance.
Okay. I made a generous offer, but I really need that belt.
Battle her? That's not very nice. We'll just... I'd say we just refuse Zeus's request.
Zorback?
Banana peel. Psst. You know why Zooster really wants a belt, right?
What did you say?
Shh. You didn't hear it from me, but Zooster wants to be the king of the Furies.
We won't stand for that.
Shh. I bet he's going to make one of his bird cow attendants queen. Are you willing to stand for that? Look, there, Dekia is now just finishing attacking your queen.
Get the Dragon Lord!
It's been too long since I've had a bit of fun like that.
Don't wink at me, Zorbank, no. You've killed our queen. Oh, she's not dead, just unconscious. It's happened to me many times. Just lay her by a healing pad and she'll be fine in a few minutes. You will pay for this. You'll never leave our lands alive, let alone conscious. Oh, here we go. That was a really nice belt she had. You should see about having a similar one made for you before handing this one over to Zooster. Triple threat? Zooster didn't give me many details in his latest letter for you. He said he wants to meet you on Mount Beef Olympus to explain in person. He certainly has a flair for the dramatic, doesn't he? Good luck, Dekia. I can't imagine what he'd be asking of you this time. There you are, Dekia. It is good to see you again. I have to say, you've been doing quite well at all these tasks I've set you. I am impressed. You really do seem to be proving yourself worthy, but I'm tempted to really test your limits now. I've envied Death's security. I would be quite appreciative if you could bring me Triskelos, the beast that guards the gates to the underworld. I'm sure Death will be thrilled to have me back wandering his realm. From slaying deadly creatures to obtaining rare objects, you have managed to succeed at all the tasks so far. This one shouldn't present much more difficulty. So, find it, capture it, bring it back. That doesn't sound too hard. Shouldn't there be a guardian at the gate? Yeah. Here we have a point of no return. And it looks like you can heal by going to that water, but we don't need that. We returned from the point of no return, by the way. What the heck? I knew I'd find its den sooner or later. Now to wrestle it into submission. What? Oh! Ah, hello little fellas. You're pretty cute, aren't you? I've been all over this realm. Searched near rivers hotter than Xan's temper and in corners cold enough to see snow. Who knew parts of the underworld had frozen over? Next thing you know, pigs will fly. And I will still haven't found that monster. I can't think surrounded by these noisy little... Oh, I would wonder if you'd like to meet a real live chicken cow. Think how fun it would be to chase one of those. You, over there, I will call you Spot, since you will be mine and you will be my Spot. I mean, you will be Zeus's fierce guard monster once you grow up. Stop! These beasts are not for the likes of you! Death, shouldn't you be resurrecting hapless heroes and counting the favors they owe you? How did you get past my gate guard? Oh, yeah, well, it wasn't there when I entered. Actually, I didn't see it guarding the gates when I came down here last time either. You might want to think about some obedience training, you know, sit, speak, stay. It seems to be having a problem with that last one. Anyways, look at how much Spot here likes me. I think he'll love living up on Mount Beef Olympus with Zooster, don't you? I'm sure he wouldn't mind you visiting if you start to miss this little guy. Zeus is really quite hospitable when he is in the mood to be.
If your chicken cow god wants one of my creatures, you'll have to deal with me. Be reasonable, Death. You've got more than enough of these beasts to guard your gates. One little puppy won't make a difference. There's no need to make Zooster come all the way down here. Especially not when he's requiring me to bring one back. You shall not pass! Oh, extreme fights! Yeah, let's do Death on extreme mode. Oh, he does not have that much HP. He has 75 immobility resistance, so we are not going to risk that with a stun and just defend for now. Oh, he blocks our attacks now. It was kind of... Yeah, alright. Good to know. This attack is also very cool. But we can still dodge it. Alright, he is not blocking anymore, so we are lowering his immobility resistance in preparation of a stun. And our dragon succeeds in one a one-turn stun, which leaves him wide open for our attack with our shield that gives us the three-turn stun. And by that time, he was long gone. I almost said dead, but he is death, I guess. He is mega death. That was not an extreme battle, come on. Here you go, one guard beast straight from the underworld. But this is not what I asked for, Dekia. You said you wanted the beast like the one Death uses to guard the underworld. I said I wanted Triskelos. That beast is large and ferocious and will intimidate any who dare trespass on my mount. This little ball of fluff and bones wouldn't frighten a Sneevil. It is of no use to me. You don't want it? But look at it, it's adorable. Yes, which makes it completely unfit for intimidation. I'm surprised at you, Dekia. For the first time, you have failed me. Wait, what? But I brought you a guard beast from the underworld. I had to battle Death again. I have to think on what you can do to restore my faith in you. I am a kind and generous god, as you know, so you will have a chance to redeem yourself. Leave me now to think. And take that little beast with you. Come on, Spots. Let's go and see if Serenity has a couple of balls and some kibble. I might as well keep you. It's not like Triskelos can leave the underworld to come take you back, right? It looks like you're mine. Although I bet you'd make a pretty good guard dog for Cicero's store, too. Let's go show you to him. And that means you can buy Spots as a pet from Cicero's store of savings with dragon coins. You might not have found Triskelos, but you got a really cute pet in this place. Ooh, Death's Cowl has a helmet. In 2 levels we will be able to use that. That's pretty handy. Alright. A titanic task. Dekia, Zooster wants to see you right away. He says it's an emergency and if you can help him now, it will more than make up for your last attempt. You should head up to Mount Beef Lempus as soon as you can. There you are, Dekia. We have a serious problem.
We do?
Yes, one of my supplicants has brought word that there are chicken cow eggs outside our nurseries. He heard that they were being kept locked away in some walled enclosure guarded by a hideous monster. My attendants are frantic and the common chicken cows are running around as if their heads were cut off.
Okay.
Someone is thieving our chicks before they've even hatched. What kind of person would do something like that? If you could find out who is behind this and return our unhatched young, I would not be the only one indebted to you. For you, Zooster, anything. If this doesn't convince him I'm worthy, nothing will. Chick elves are far too adorable to let anything happen to them. I would be happy to help.
road to ruin or road less traveled. Should always choose the road less traveled by, like that one poem. Warning, do not stare directly into the sun. Or the eyes of an oversized snake monster. Alright.
What will it be this time? Wrestling a mutant dog? Fighting a snake woman?
Titan battle? No, well... Yeah, sure. Yeah, it's without a dragon. Battle... Medusa? Oh, as in dew, as in it's a garden? Oh, great. Weak to fire, I believe we have elementized ourselves to fire. Oh, we can't change it at this time. We'll see then. We can probably stun her. Yes, we get the stun. As you can see, we've now unlocked all of our skills for our dragon. Even this last skill here, Mega Burn, in which we attack a couple of times. Yeah, wow. But over half her health is gone now. She stares at us intently. Oh. She does not do a lot of damage. That's good. We are already very strong with our Titan Dragon, aren't we? Maybe it's about time that we soon get our primal skill. Victory. Complete the quest to enter the garden. Whoever built this must have a green thumb. With what you had to face to get into this garden, it's a good thing that you got here well before midnight. Who knows what would be prowling then? I'm moonwalking now! Oh my god, what? It's brilliant. So, I think we've broken the game. We're going to log out real quick. Alright, that has fixed the issue. Now we are nearing the end of the bacon story. Inside the garden. What are you doing back here? I can't wait to hear what you discovered inside the garden. My thumbs are quite normal, actually. Unless I hit them with something, then they're a pretty awesome shade of pulsing blue-purple. Not green, though. Sorry. Never seen them that color, except for the time I was enhancing Warlick's bathrobe with that dye. But that hardly counts. Cicero? What are you doing here? Waiting for inspiration to strike. And by inspiration, I mean one of those eggs up there in this tree. No, I mean, what are you doing here, in this garden? It's my garden, why wouldn't I be here? You have a garden? What? I have things, why wouldn't I have things? Recently I discovered one of them was a garden. I could have sworn it was an outhouse before, but hey, you work with what you've got. But what is it for? Plants, I think. Or planting plants? It looks like a lot of my nature-based magical experiments have wound up here. Did you see the snozzberry bush over there? It tastes like snozzberries. Whoever heard of a snozzberry? No one, but I had this dream and after an afternoon in my workshop. Wait, did you say you were waiting for an egg to fall? Yep, look up. This tree seems to be full of them. They look pretty ripe too. Do eggs get ripe? There are chicken cow eggs, growing, on this tree. That's what it looks like to me too, and they're pretty big. I bet one of them would make 3 omelets. And what a tree, it sprung up last week shortly after I spilled that sparkly pink stuff on my plate of fried eggs, I think. I tossed my ruined breakfast out the window since, for some reason, Warlick says the library isn't the right place for storing ruined food. I argued that the ruined food cabinet was already full, but he wouldn't have it. Why would chicken cow eggs grow on a tree? That makes no sense. Sure it does. You just need to look at it the right way. Fruit comes from trees, right? Yes. And chicken cow eggs come from chicken cows, right? I never really wanted to think about that, but I suppose that's logical. So, a chicken cow egg is also a chicken cow tree seed. same thing, or close enough for government work. The tree just needed a little convincing to see things that way. This one is bearing chicken cow fruit. Makes sense to me. But, so this tree is a chicken cow? Of course not, it's a tree. Do you need glasses? Yep, as soon as they fall, breakfast is mine. I just need to wait for one to drop, and I've got nothing better to do. And I'm hungry. So they wait. Any minute now. After a few minutes. And a few more minutes. Getting very hungry now. Oh. You think you can just fall on me? We'll see about that. See you, Dekia. I need to introduce this egg to my pals. Skillet, fork and ketchup. Cicero, wait! Fine, no ketchup. Can I at least take these other eggs back to Zooster? Huh? Sure, go ahead. Knock yourself out. Before one of those soon-to-be-scrambled eggs does it for you. Oh, one last question. That gigantic snake lady, what was she here for? She's guarding the garden, of course. Hilarious. And you should see what I've got by the back gate. Dekia, I cannot believe you've done it. You should be able to, after everything else I've managed to do for you. You are right. You are a dragon lord of rare skill and jests of incredible worth. We owe you a great deal. Ah, well, someone had to think of the children, chick elves. They belong with their parents, not on a tree or as... never mind. We don't understand how someone managed to take the eggs. Did you determine that? And the identity of the thief? Well, you see, they weren't actually stolen. I'm not sure how they got into that tree in Cicero's garden. But I'm pretty sure a magic powder, a plate of eggs, and a space-time vortex in the warlock's kitchen window had something to do with it. It's Cicero. You don't really want to ask too many questions. Very understandable. But the eggs are back is what's important. So please, name your reward, Dekia. You do remember why I've been doing all these tasks for you, don't you? Yes, vaguely. Something about wanting something very important. I have so many supplicants, it's hard to keep track of all those requests, you know. Bacon! I want to know the secrets of element bacon. I've been helping you for months, and you didn't even know why? I was sure you had a good reason. So, will you tell me the secrets of element bacon now? Of course. Anyone who has served my people so well is more than deserving enough to know one of our most well-kept secrets. I will have to prepare the mage priests, though, as the story is really theirs to tell. A letter will be sent to your acquisitive, purple-haired friend by the statue when all is ready. You really, really don't want to know what is guarding the back gate.
Zooster says everything is ready. He and Archimedes will meet you in the Mage Priest Temple at midnight. He really does take the phrase mysterious to heart, doesn't he? We've waited long enough. Go find out his secret. Dekia, after all you've done for us, you've earned the right to hear this tale. We ask that you do not reveal what you will tell you to anyone except the woman who sent you on this quest for knowledge. Can do. Now, what's the secret? I've waited for months to learn this. Chicken cows are not very used to mixing with the other residents of Lore. Cluck cluck. Moo? Which is why your people have not that much interaction with us. I want to eat him. We had been flourishing on Lore, though, I can assure you. Life was good, we were successful, and our young chicken cows grew strong. More and more we were thriving, and our population increased in both health and happiness. But we arrived at the point where we began doing too well. The abundance of food began to be a problem. So we mage priests did what any good followers would do. We decided to beseech our god in the hope that he would have a ready solution to our problem. We prepared a prayer spell which would formally request that Zooster provide us with a cheap, easy and abundant source of nutritious food. The symbol for request, for abundant, the symbol for food and the symbol for... Oh, Chickencow. The glyphs for this spell were fairly complex, and ancient tomes had to be consulted in order to recall how the individual glyphs and runes should appear, in order to ensure the success of the spell. At last, almost ready for the ceremony, we guarded the senior apprentices so that they might witness the event. The seriousness of the ceremony ensured that they would behave appropriately.
Yeah, check this out.
I can't wait to see old Aki Moody's face. Hi, wingman, that was righteous. So, how did it go? We surveyed the strange food our god had sent us, but we were quite confused. This was not the corn/hay mixture we had been anticipating. One of my most learned priests, Chikero, bravely tasted a bite of the stuff. That bad, eh? He assured me it was most certainly not edible. Oh yes, it might do to feed you humans, but something about it didn't seem right. There was an otherworldly feel to it as he chewed and swallowed. Another priest voiced his concern and asked firstly how such a thing could happen, as our god had never failed us before, and secondly, he wondered what exactly it was that Zeuster had sent us. I returned to the runes and glyphs to understand where we could have gone wrong. Our god would not have done this to us purposefully. I felt we must have made an error in our prayer, and I saw that I was correct. Okay, that's request. And this is abundant. Good, good. The glyph for food had been altered. It changed to what loosely translates to substance most basic, or as you would understand it, elemental. Oh, stink. And the rune for chicken cow had been changed beyond all recognition to what you see there. We have never seen a symbol like this. I can only speculate that from this garbled rune a substance never known before was created. So, whoops. We knew then that we would need to speak to our god directly. Only he could explain what had happened. So what happened then? You can't just cut off there. You must understand, Akia, when my supplicants pray to me, I'm not always paying conscious attention. I would never be able to concentrate with the constant requests for my attention and favor. The nature of my existence allows for shortcuts. If my subconscious hears a request that seems acceptable, it grants it. That is what happened here. Because of the garbled glyphs, and how that happened we still do not know, our prayers went awry. So, this stuff, it's bacon. That's an element? And it was a mistake? Yes, you can see why we didn't advertise its creation. Since we couldn't eat it and we had no idea what to do with it, we decided to get rid of it. We knew of a black market run by an elf out in the Sand Sea. We were sure that no one could trace this stuff back to us. We were quite surprised when weapons made of bacon started turning up around lore. I discreetly investigated and found that the proprietress of a battle arena bought a whole mound of it. And Kelia had made weapons from it. You'd need a pretty insane weaponsmith to do that. Indeed. I've never heard of a new element just being created. There's much of lore you do not know, Dekia. I have one more question before I return to Valencia and tell her all of this. Ask. If this is a true element, then is there an elemental orb of bacon? Yes, there is. It is not one of the originals, but it does exist. It comes from a place beyond our understanding, outside our reality. A place that smells like breakfast. And that would be our reality, I assume. And we can buy weapons with the element bacon, which might be fun and useful at some point, but they are very expensive, so we'll skip that for now. Complete quest. The first rule of element bacon, you do not talk about element bacon, except to Valencia. The secret is finally revealed. Gruber's revenge. Why don't you go and visit that cute puppy you brought back from the underworld? Make sure Cicero hasn't turned it into a two-headed fish. Take it for a walk. Alright. Whew, I never would have guessed that Zeuster and the chicken cows could keep such a secret. I mean, anything bacon-related is sure to interest someone, so eventually the truth will be well-known, I think. And I'm discussing current events with a two-headed dog. I wonder if Sir Jin has time to see me. Don't worry, boys, I'm not mad at you. How about some water? There's a fountain nearby. What's the matter, boys? There's nothing to be scared of. The town's all peaceful today. Let's keep walking. Gah! What are you doing here? You're confined to the underworld. It's Triskelos.
I want my child. You stole them.
Oh, you're pretty growly, you know that? I'm going to call you Gerberus. It fits much better than your current name. Two, I didn't steal them. They came willingly.
Quiet, Peps. Dekia, if you do not return my child to me, I will take them.
Spots and spots, I'll leave it up to you. Do you want to go back to that dark, cold underworld or stay up here and play? Just as I thought, play it is. Gerberus, if you take me on, the responsibility of your doom is on your head. Or, well, all three of them. Battling Gerberus. Weak to light, resistant to darkness, and low immobility resistance. So we're going to go for a stun here. Ah, we don't get it. Maybe our dragon can stun him? No, we are bad luck with that. Alright, we'll just have to defend then. We're taking quite some damage, so we'll continue to block with our earth shield and then heal using our healing skill. This is the most difficult fight of the storyline. And there we go, he turns to stone.
It looks like you really do care about my pups, Dekia. You may keep them, but I'll be keeping an eye on you. Six of them.
Hear that, pups? You get to stay with me and Cicero. Just think what fun tricks we'll teach you. I wonder what you'd bring back if Cicero teaches you fetch. Probably something like a right pink bunny slipper with fangs. Quest complete and we get a Chickencow teeth. Wait, I didn't think these existed. Go figure. Yeah, that's a good point actually. And with that Chickencow teeth, we can go to a merch shop, which we have unlocked by doing all of these quests. Over here, merch shop. And we can get the evolved Chickencow armor. We can buy the Chickencow armor for 45 dragon coins in Cicero's store. And then merge it with this Chickencow teeth to actually turn it into an armor that has some decent skills. Because the original Chickencow armor is more of a joke armor. I might consider actually doing that. I quite like that. And it's not a lot of dragon coins. You only have 200 dragon coins because that's what you get when you have a dragon amulet as a standard. But now you can also do these daily quests and earn 3 daily dragon coins. That's not a lot, but you know, 45 dragon coins is easy to replace doing that. So I might consider doing that and on occasion wear the Chickencow armor. I hope you enjoyed the story of the bacon origins. I know it took a while for this episode to come out. I'm sorry about that. I think it must have been about 3 weeks when I'm done editing this. I do want to make use of this point to thank you for 1,000 subscribers. I know I don't deserve it. I've gotten very, very lucky with that one video of me fighting Sepulcher. But I am very grateful. It has given me the excuse I needed to do this DragonFable Let's Play. And I've been having a blast doing it. And you're the ones who made that possible. So really, thank you. And also thank you for all the likes and kind comments that I've been getting. It really means a lot. So, next time we will continue with the Light Orb. In your adventures across the Kingdom of Greenguard, you've come across the village of Duet in the harsh desert of the Sand Sea. There you stumble across a rebel who promises the location of the Light Orb, but the ranger slash mercenary Zoom stands in your way. It seems you'll have to work with him to find your way to the Light Orb. It is a story of emperors, of traitors, of rebellions, and of sandwiches. I hope you look forward to that. And we'll do that with the Soul Weaver armor, by the way, because the poll has finished now. And we are going to do that with the Soul Weaver armor, together with our soul ally, Aegis. As always, stay safe, and until next time.